So I know I haven't talked about this much, but some of my more observant viewers may have noticed that I adore good villains. Often, I'm totally okay with watching subpar shows as long as there is an amazing villain thrown in there. Not to mention, they just always seem to be that extra bit of spice that can turn any good show into an amazing one. Some of my favorites include Homelander from The Boys, Hisoka from Hunter x Hunter, Hans from Inglourious Basterds, and the Joker from The Dark Knight. Hell, I even loved Thanos from Infinity Wars, and I'm not even really a fan of the MCU. These villains are fantastic for many different reasons, and they're all great because not a single one is evil for the sake of being evil. Hell, I would argue that most of them believe that they are secretly the good guys. Well, maybe not the two clowns. But they are all different types of characters with unique traits that just pull you in and draw out fear. But the key word there isn't exactly fear. It's being unique. A lot of villains often feel pretty similar. I mean, you guys know the type, the giant laser beams and destroying the Earth. But these villains are special because they are a megalomaniac with godlike abilities and no one to keep him in check, a killer clown with insane strategic prowess and a penchant for pure chaos, another killer clown, except this one has a strange interest in children, but also swings back and forth from being an enemy and an ally. I mean, I could go on, but I think you guys get the idea. Each intriguing villain has something that just makes them unique and pulls you in. So when My Hero Academia first started and the villain of Shigaraki was introduced, my first thought was, oh well, I guess there won't be any good villains in this anime. Shigaraki was cartoonishly evil. He was, for a lack of a better expression, a bumbling idiot without a clue or a reason, trying to cause chaos and just failing miserably. I did not like Shigaraki at the beginning of the series. He seemed one-dimensional, almost the villain of the week kind of character. But luckily enough, I was wrong. Shigaraki is basically Midoriya in some ways. He can be looked at like a protagonist. He starts off as this weak character with some really basic morals. Yet over the series, Shigaraki has evolved. Evolved into what I believe to be a true villain with nuances, goals, and of course, something that actually makes him unique. Much like our Midoriya has evolved from a hopeful kid to someone who can be called a hero with his own nuances and goals. This is what's pretty unique about Shigaraki as a villain. Midoriya and Shigaraki represent this duality of hero versus villain. I mean, both basically have adopted fathers, one being the All for One user, and the other being the previous One for All user. Both took Midoriya and Shigaraki under their wings, respectively, and mentored them until All for One was beaten and captured by One for All, only to basically force All Might into an early retirement. In other words, both were forced to leave their mentor's wings at the same time, leading up to the most recent arc with the character of Overhaul, where they both have their first real chance to prove their abilities of being a hero and a villain, and both succeed with flying colors. Shigaraki is more than just your average villain. Like I've said, each villain I've adored in media has always had something special that separated them from the masses. And with Shigaraki, that is his ability to grow as a character. Shigaraki is treated like the protagonist of his own story, and that just makes him terrifying. I mean, let's just run through the entirety of the Overhaul arc. Twice accidentally brings in Overhaul to meet Shigaraki, not knowing anything about Overhaul, and Overhaul promptly kills one of their team members, along with seriously injuring another, only to drop a business card and invite his crew to work under Overhaul. The first real change we see is that Shigaraki actually accepts the invite with no real malice. Do keep in mind that Shigaraki used to throw temper tantrums over the smallest things. So seeing Shigaraki for once holding back his anger really hints that something is different about him. Like I said, he shows up to Overhaul's meeting, he keeps his cool for the most part, and is lectured to by Overhaul about how everything is like a game of shoji. He accepts Overhaul's conditions and works together and more or less follows through on that promise. Yet, there is a really crucial scene that occurs. It starts when Shigaraki is telling Twice and Toga that they are going to work for Overhaul. When they start getting mad about it and asking why they should listen to Shigaraki, Shigaraki takes off his mask, and you can see that he's not mad, and actually quite understanding. Shigaraki says that he has something in the works, and that most importantly, Shigaraki truly trusts them to do the right thing. Just a quick reminder, Shigaraki used to try to kill anyone who dared talk back to him, and now we see someone basically threatening to kill him, and we see Shigaraki keep his cool and follow his own plan. Which, by the way, works. Shigaraki gives Toga and Twice full reign to do whatever they want, and they end up basically dismantling the entire organization. Not only that, they use the information they got to corner Overhaul and, well, exact poetic justice on him. Shigaraki comes back and steals all of Overhaul's hard work right in front of him, basically proving that Shigaraki isn't this idiot he was going to overthrow with ease like Overhaul had expected. Not only that, but then we see Shigaraki destroy both of Overhaul's arms so he'll be quirkless for the rest of his life. He looks Overhaul dead in the eyes and tells him, "Hey, don't you think it's a bit contradictory for someone who is trying to destroy all quirks, relying so heavily on their own?" And he walks away looking like an absolute badass. Tell me that's not poetic. This is the first time we see Shigaraki actually win. We see him being this leader and actually putting trust into some of his comrades, and it pays off huge. Not only did he turn what was originally a bad situation into a good one, he abuses his opponent's arrogance and crushes his entire organization while also reaping all of the benefits. This is grade A villaining right here. He gets wronged by some guy, he pretends he's compromising, then turns the entire situation on its head while getting literally everything he wanted, plus a little extra. This is one of the first scenes in the anime where Shigaraki began looking less like a spoiled brat and more like a truly unique villain. Thank you guys for watching. Sorry, I know I gush about Shigaraki a lot, but he's just such an amazing villain. A huge thank you to my patrons, you guys are my heroes. Speaking of which, if you're interested in seeing how I edit, joining our exclusive Discord, or simply supporting the channel, feel free to join me on Patreon. Make sure you guys share, like, comment, and subscribe. This has been Matt. Make sure you guys stay a man and go watch that goddamned anime.